Accessing and altering properties of a node is essential to programming in Godot. Most, if not all, the magic of game development in Godot happens in altering data on the properties of nodes. But how can you access those properties? If you know how to reference a certain node in your scene tree, accessing its properties becomes quite simple. This video is complementary to my Access Any Node in Your Scene Tree video, which will be linked at the end of this video and in the description below. So if you don't know how to access nodes in a scene tree yet, be sure to give it a watch after this one. This is a beginner's video and accessing properties of nodes is fairly simple. Which properties of each node can be accessed are shown by clicking on the node in the scene tree to the left and then clicking on the drop-down sections in the inspector to the right. If you're not completely new and already learned how to move a character, you already made the first step by altering the velocity and the position of a body, which is basically the same as altering its rotation or its size, its visibility, or even the color. If you hover with your mouse over one of these properties, you can see its name on how you should address it. Please note that they are never in uppercase and always in lowercase. And you should also know that if you want to change any of these properties, they all require different data types to manipulate them. Position, for example, has an X and Y value, which requires a vector 2 to change them, just as with the scale. Rotation has a float value, so you can either feed it integers or a float value. Visibility, for example, is a Boolean. It's either true or false. And the modulate is its own thing. He needs even 4 different pieces of data in order to change the color by code. But let's not dwell on that for now. We are going to move the position. Now, what you can do is from the position that requires 2 values, specify that you only want to access, for example, the X value. This is what we're going to do now to move a character to the right. So jumping into a script and in a process function, I just call on the position that I want to change and the X value. And I will add to that 1 pixel each process cycle. And with this, we are going to move our character to the right. Cool. I can do the same with the rotation. I just call on to the rotation. And I will add maybe not as much and give it a spin. But you will see something weird happening here right now. And the reason for that is that Godot, if you only call onto the name of the property that you want to change, it always tries to take the property of the node that the script is attached to. In our case, what we're changing is the rotation of the main node, which if we change it here, we are rotating around the axis, which is here in the corner. What we want to do is rotate our sprite around its own center. So jumping back into our script, what we have to do here is always specify which node we want to change the property on. In this case, it is our sprite 2D. And then after that, we always write a dot. And then we give it the name of the property that we want to change. So with this, our rotation should change only on the sprite and not on the whole node. Fabulous. As you can see, it is extremely important to always get the correct node, which we then can change its property on. And to find the proper node in our scene tree, I highly recommend you to watch my Access Any Node in Your Scene Tree video, linked at the end. Now let's take 2 more Guinea pigs and make 2 more examples out of it. So I want to have another sprite 2D and duplicate that one as well. And we will give them names blue, and the other one will be red, and the other one will be green. And then we will quickly change the color in the ready function. So this one is not existent anymore. This one was the blue, like that. Then I take the red and change its modulate to be the color dot red, and I will do the same with our green. Awesome. Like this, they are blue, red, and green. And we will then change some properties of these as well. For my green one, I want to make it bigger. So I call the scale property and I give it a vector 2 of 1 and 1. Actually not give, but add. So green has currently the transform and scale 1 and 1. When we add another 1 and 1 to it, it is going to be 2 and 2. So basically doubling in size. Then I want the red one, maybe we actually move this, so red one will be changing its position so that we move slowly to the right bottom corner. Also give it a vector 2, and that will be 1 pixel for X and 1 pixel for Y every frame. Now with this, we have changed quite a few properties here. Awesome. And that's already it for the video. Be sure to watch this one next to see how you can access any node in your scene trees so that you can change any properties on them. See you in the next one.